Sure. I'll be around.
Thanks.
Now.
Ivy's only bluffing. That he won't stop him from taking the stage.
But you think he meant it?
My own father's ganged up with Ivy against the man I'm going to marry. Don't you understand what I'm up against?
Yes, ma'am.
Valley's public grazing land. Walt has as much right there as anyone.
But he's threatened to bring in sheep. This is cattle country. You know how sheep ruin a country for cattle.
How many men will be there when the stage comes in?
I don't know. You saw your father in his hands at the blacksmith shop.
I told Dad if one of his men mixed in this, I'd never set foot in his house again.
There's still Frank Ivey.
Will you stick by me?
He helped me when I needed.
Thanks. Dave, what if Walt takes the stage? He does bring in sheep.
He will need to bring them in. If he makes the stage tonight, he'll control the valley. No, you won't. The whole town knows how you wanted to marry. If you're there, they'll say Walt's hiding behind your skirts. It's one sure way of ruining it. Ivy's back.
Stage ready. Get aboard.
Made up your mind, sheep man?
I'm going.
Are you? I see you're drunk.
Listen, Ivy, you're not God. You can't keep a man off the stage.
Throw down his valise, Harry. He's not gone.
Frank Ivey sent you.
No. Only I just thought on account of tonight you might want to come home.
Connie, are you hurt about Walt throwing you over?
You have such a thoughtful way of putting it. Walt didn't throw me over. He just took one look at you and Frank and decided he didn't love me enough to die for me.
Now why?
It's the truth. He gave you a wonderful excuse with his threat to bring in sheep. Now you and Frank are right back where you started from, hoping I'll be impressed enough to marry him while I'm not, and I'm clearing out.
I don't understand you. First, I thought you were just headstrong. When you were little, I used to get a kick out of seeing you stand up and fight for what you wanted. But, Connie, tonight men could have been killed on account of you.
Could have been, Dad, but they weren't. From now on, I'm going to make a life of my own. And being a woman, I won't have to use guns.
Connie!
And there's something else you might as well hear now. This isn't just a fight between father and daughter. You pushed Frank Ivey at me ever since I can remember. For years, I've watched him run things his way. The town, the valley, you, and now me! No one's ever had the nerve to stand up to him. Well, I have. And I'm warning you, Dad, don't get in my way, and that goes for Frank Ivey. Now get out! Get out!
What are you going to do now?
Drift. Where's Bill?
Oh, you know Bill. He'll hang around town for a week, raising Cain. Then all of a sudden he's gone.
Hit it with it. Rose. Present for you.
Lovely. Oh, it was sweet of you, but Martin Bondurant has already told his wife about the expensive silks and punch you bought him. If I appeared in a dress of the same material.
I never thought of that.
Of course you did. Dave, what's the matter? Sit down. Where did you get it off the chest? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to pry.
You're not, Ross. I lost my wife when our son was born. He would have been six just 3 weeks ago.
Would have been?
Yeah. I was buying cattle in a small way and had to travel most of the time, so I left him with some friends. While I was gone, their house burned. He was in it, sleeping. They died too, trying to save him.
The liquor didn't help.
Bill Shell's crazy talk didn't help either. It was you, Rose. Putting up with us, laughing, cheerful, not asking questions, I wiped it out. That's why I wanted to thank you.
If you don't mind, I'd like to keep this after all.
If you don't mind, I think I'll have that supper after all.
I thought you'd mind.
Thank you. stay and fight. I'd stick a note under my door and run. Just wasn't strong enough, was he?
No.
But I am. Strong enough to beat both Dad and Ivy at their own business. They broke off and I'm going to fight back. I'll make Circle 66 an outfit they'll respect. I want you to run it.
No, ma'am.
Why not?
They didn't break off. They were just fighting sheep, like any cattleman.
They'd break any man I wanted. They'd find a reason. Like they made sheep the reason for breaking them off. But I'll never turn to Frank Ivey. A little money of my own. Enough to buy some cattle and hire a crew. They won't break anybody when I get through with them.
Connie, you better let Link drive you home now that your sheep herder has thrown you over.
Thanks, Link. But I'm not going home. Walt left me his ranch and I'm moving in on Valley Grass.
What?
All I can hold.
Oh, well, now, wait a minute. You're just excited. Well, you don't think we'd let you steal our grass?
It's free range.
Well, I warn you, there'll be gunplay. Men'll get hurt.
Your men, too.
What's come over you, Connie? You changed. You're so hard, so...
Coming from you, that's a compliment. Looks like we won the first round.
Not we. This is your fight.
You afraid?
When I take the count, it'll be for my own mistakes. I can draw my wages. I'm drifting.
I'll leave it over to Special Saloon. If you change your mind, come back. You'll always have a job as long as I have a ranch.
Thanks.
Hi, Dave. Miss Dickason sent this over for you.
Thanks.
Now,
Jim,
hey, your boss ran out on you. Now you'll have to get a new sucker to pay for your dress, won't you, Goose Head?
I'm so careful, Red.
Sounds like Shipley, doesn't it?
He just talked.
So do you.
I didn't stay out of it.
Well, there are other places.
You too.
Sometimes it's hard to choose between friendship and duty.
And you've been a sheriff a long time.
How are you, kid?
It's all right. He's a friend of mine.
Good fight, kid. What do you want to go to work for? I miss you. How's Rose?
She's fine. You want to dodge?
I kissed a fellow's girl last night. She always thought she might be him.
Now, how'd you like to go to work?
To work? What for? I still got some money.
How do you stack up with Frank Ivey?
I worry him. I have too much fun to shoot him. I don't like him either. He makes too big tracks.
Walt Shipley gave Connie Dickason his ranch last night. She's out to get Ben and Frank. I'm hard enough to.
You're not like me, kid. You don't fight for pay.
Ivey ordered me out of town.
Call me,
under my orders, Bill. That's the way it's got to be. I don't take the job.
Sure. That's the way to be, kid.
We ought to have 3 or 4 more men.
I get 50 men to work for nothing. Just for one crack at Ivey. One of the druggies?
I don't care. But they've got to pass with Jim Crew.
Jim Crew? What's he got to do with it?
The sheriff's on blue chip. Anything we do against Ivy's got to be legal.
All right. It's a deal.
We know who we're fighting, and now's the time to take him apart.
I give the orders around here, and we're playing this on the square, remember?
All right. All right, kid. You're the Ramrod of this outfit.
Wait here until I get back.
If you're so set on running a ranch, Donnie, you can have mine. Anytime you want it.
You and I would get along a lot better if you'd pull back to your side of American Creek.
Let you grab half the grass? What if I won't?
Then I'll have to take it.
That kind of fight is supposed to be for men. Think you're tough enough?
She thinks her phone is pretty tough, Dave Nash.
Yeah, he'll be drunk when she needs the most.
That's my risk. You've heard my proposition. Do I get the grass or not?
I said I'd stick by whatever Frank said. I've been doing it so long, it's got to be a habit.
Miss Connie here?
Yes, she is.
How's your nose, Red?
Don't worry, I can still smell with it. Right now, I'm sorry.
Come in, Dave.
No thanks.
Hello, Dave.
I came to help you.
Thank you. That's sweet of you.
How's everything at the Circle 66?
Just fine. Everything's cozy and warm.
You still insist on leaving, Connie? Just what do you expect to get out of this?
Wages. And something Shipley said got me curious.
What was that?
He said Ivey wasn't gone. Ivey says he is. I want to see who's right. I'll wait for you outside, Miss Connie.
Job. Come on in.
Good idea.
Dave, they're all here.
Come on in. Got a job, just forgot credit. Dave, this is Ed Berman. Ivy's top Ramrod.
I'll remember this, you saddle tramp.
Get the buckboard up here. Come on, get out. Come on, get going, all of you. Hurry it up. Virgily, kind of hanging, we'd know right through the rope. And just more. He likes to play injured.
We'll be back.
Anytime.
Miss Dickinson, does your old man know about this?
You can tell Ben and Ivy, Miss Dickinson will be glad to trade houses with him. Tell him it's for keeps.
I'll tell him.
They sure sad bunch. Where do we put it?
Oh, anywhere, I guess.
After traveling all night, I'm sure hungry.
Me too.
Well, there's plenty of food here for our outfit.
Hey, this ain't bad.
That's going to be just fine, Curly.
Well, it ain't very stylish the way you're used to it.
It'll be all right when it's clean. Give me a hand here, will you, Curly?
You aim to wash this place?
Well, at least I can scald a few spiders. Looks like we're going to have visitors.
Good morning, Connie. How's my little land fee?
I'm not your little anything. Besides, this land was filed on today. Seems you neglected that little item when you built it.
So I found out. There is clever of you, Connie.
Cleverness was my foreman's. Since we're very busy, I'll thank you to get off my ground.
Your foreman's new in this country. I wonder who told him I hadn't filed. Burge, bring Curly over.
We have a legal right to be here. You can't put us off this land.
Oh, I can't. But I can discourage your men.
All right, Burge.
Stop it, Dave. Two of Ivy's men held him while Burge leaves.
Don't waste time talking. We've got to get him to bed. Take him to Rose's. I'll get the doctor.
To Rose's?
Hurry up, Connie.
Yeah. Was he dragged by a horse?
No.
I'll relieve you later. Sorry, Dave. Somebody has to cry for him, I guess.
That's you, Rose.
I'll pay Frank Ivey back for this if it's the last thing I do.
Ed Berman's down there. Let's send him back to Ivey in a basket. You do and I ride out of here.
They did it to Curly.
Who are you fighting, Ivey or Berman?
Ivey.
Then fight him. Get some sense into that thick little head of yours. That's what they want. We make a wrong move and cruise on their side.
He won't back up your own men.
It's got to be my way.
Thank you.
want you to deputize me.
To go after Burns? Lindstrom and I have already tended to that.
Where is he?
Ben and Ivey's going his bail. 3,000. Ben's bringing it in.
I'd have done better.
I take my law from the book, Dave. Burge will go to the pen for this. And if Curly dies...
Burge dies.
But it better be legal. Mind you that.
Hello, Burma. You hear about Curly?
I had nothing to do with that. I don't want no trouble, Bill.
You ain't got two men to hold me like the hell Curly. Won't take a chance without him, will you?
If I have a mind to fight, nobody has to hold for me.
What'll it take to give you a mind?
Right now, an awful lot. I won't be rawhided into this. I ain't gonna draw. They all see my hands. I ain't gonna draw.
Before Bill could draw.
Here's his gun. This had better be true.
Sure, it's been fired, all right. What were you doing all this time?
While he was shooting fast, I was aiming careful. Ask George.
Well, I... Sure, and I'll ask Pokey, too. When we find him. He sure lit out quick.
Guess he was scared. Bill ain't the kind to wait for two shots before he moves.
How'd he get this burn on his hand?
Well, Bill laid his cigar down. Maybe Bummer put his hand on it.
Happens to be on the back of his hand.
Well, he fell on his back. It might have been under his hand.
You two are lying. Jim, George and Bill have been in cahoots for years. You put Burge on the bond. Why don't you do the same here?
Sure, and if Curly dies and Burma's been murdered, Bill and Burge will both hang. I can't hang a man for self-defense.
Burma's dead, and all Curly had was a poke in the nose.
Ben, I'd like to show you what a poke in the nose can do.
I don't want to see it, I'm afraid.
Connie saw it.
Lindstrom.
I'd like to take care of Curly and pay all of his expenses.
Paying his expenses won't restore his sight.
I don't want to fight with her, Rose. She's all I've got.
She's got a pride, Ben. You broke a man in front of her. You don't know how a woman feels when a man like Frank do that.
Maybe, but she wouldn't have loved Walt Shipley. He was trash.
What's Frank Ivey?
The biggest man in the valley. I get Connie's side of it, Dave, but I don't get yours. Are you after Connie?
Well, just pretend you never asked that.
Hello, Bill.
Hello, Connie. Where is everybody?
Around.
Sure could do with a cup of coffee.
First.
George said so, didn't he?
Did he?
Well, what do you think?
I think you're not afraid to take a chance. I like that.
What are you after, Connie?
All right, I'll tell you. I want to break Frank Ivey. I want to see him crawl out of town the same way Walt did.
If Curly dies, Dave will take care of Ivey.
Dave's way is too slow.
Just what's on your mind, Connie?
I want you to stampede my herd.
Stampede?
It's the one way to make Dave and Jim Crew move fast. Thought about it for a long time. They'll think Frank Ivey did it.
Yeah. They might.
They will.
This is something I didn't figure out.
What did you figure out?
Well, to tell the truth, then.
Why bother?
Thank you.
Hello, Rose.
Hello, Bill.
How's Curly?
I wouldn't go in now, Bill. Can you please? Wait a little while.
This is nice.
Bill, it's on his sleeve.
That's fine.
Here, give it to me and I'll fix it. With two women out of the ranch, I should think you'd be looked after better.
No one looks after me. Annie looks after Connie. Connie looks after Dave.
Who does Dave look after?
Who do you think? The cattle. Wonder what's up.
Ivey and his crew jumped us about midnight last night, cut us off in the herd and started shooting.
Yeah, part of them chased us and the other stampeded the whole herd right off the cliffs.
So Ivy's really gone wild. I never thought it.
He's always been wild.
Well, I've heard your evidence.
Remember, boys, no liquor. We got a big job ahead of us.
You men aren't going, Dave. Every one of them's got a grudge against Ivy and the law's got to be neutral.
But you'll need help, Jim.
Thanks. This is my business.
And it's my fight.
Doesn't call for shooting. But it might if you were there.
Well, you're probably right.
I know I'm right. This has been my lifetime job, son.
If you ever want to quit, I'll give you a job on my outfit. Even sign you on as Ramrod.
At my age, I take that as quite a compliment.
Says Curly won't last.
Found a bookie?
No, not yet.
Here. Something wrong, Jim?
You coming?
Coming. Where?
To jail.
Jail for what?
Stampeding Connie's cattle out of the country last night wasn't exactly legal.
What are you talking about? I wasn't off at the place last night and I can prove it.
Come here.
Where was I last night, boys?
Right here. All night. He sure was. He won a month's wages off me in the poker game.
Did you hear that?
Better put your boots on.
I told you I wasn't off the place.
You'll get a chance to prove that before a jury, Frank.
You're lying.
I'm not lying when I say I'm taking you in.
I'm warning you, Jim. Get away from here.
I'll tell you just once more. Come along.
Don't do it, Jim!
Red.
Get over to Dickerson's and spread the word that Bird shot the sheriff.
Listen, Frank,
shut your mouth. I'll take care of it. Go on. I want Dave Nash to hear about this.
Thank you.
seen what happened. You're on men stampede at your kennel. They done it on purpose. I seen them. But nobody saw me.
There must be some mistake.
No, ma'am. Tom Peebles, Bailey, and Bill Shaw. I seen them.
Sit down, Link. Link, you know Dad tried to force me to marry Frank Ivey. That's why I left home.
So I heard.
Frank fights dirty. I've got to fight the same way. Curly's dying because of him. I know Bill Shaw stabbed me to the kennel. The orders were mine.
But on account of that, Jim Crew is dead.
If I know. It's a terrible thing to have on my conscience. But I didn't know this was going to happen. Should I take all the blame?
Oh, no. Don't tell him nothing. And you don't have to worry about me, Miss Connie. I'll keep my mouth shut.
Thanks, Lee.
Frank Ivey killed the sheriff.
Afternoon.
Why don't you look in Idaho or Montana? They quit after Crew was killed.
Come on, I just wanted to be can't get far. Head back to town.
Let's get him out in the open, ain't it?
Why not? I'm innocent. Didn't I stampede those cattle and try to hang on me? Hello, Rose. How is he?
What is he?
I found out there won't be any passengers on the stage tonight. It's our only chance.
We just entered our house. Thank heaven Steph wasn't home.
All right, here they are. You two want to go out the back way and quick. Get my gun. Where's my gun? You two get out.
Wait, I have an idea. You
break, Rocky.
When I'm busy.
We won't be long, Rose. Take a look in the kitchen. Just looking around.
We'll look somewhere else, not here. Oh, Dennis. What's the matter with you, Frank?
I want Dave Nash, that's all.
Well, I haven't seen him. And if I had, I wouldn't tell you. I'll get out. Both of
them. Not until I found Dave Nash.
There's nothing in the kitchen, Frank.
He isn't here, I tell you.
We'll see.
You're not going in there. Mrs. Parks is in for a thing.
I'll take a look anyway.
You're not coming in here, Frank. I am
undressed.
I'm sorry, Mrs.
Parks.
They pushed their way in.
You better put some clothes on, Mrs. Parks. I'm coming in.
You can't come in here, and I'm not putting on any clothes for your sake. You think you're going to run this town, Frank Ivey? Well, there's one person you can't run. And I know enough about the people in this town to know you would be doing just one thing too many. I never did think decency meant anything to you.
Listen, Mrs. Parks.
You listen!
Hey, Frank, I just brought in Pokey. He said Bill Shellroy had a room to fight.
Bill Shell's dead. You may not know it, but he is.
I've got some business to take care of. When I get back, the fitting better be over.
My fitting will be over when Rose and I get things right, and not before. Bill Shell, tell me back.
Hey, Pop, come on, we're going.
Well, I'll be doggone. That's the first time I ever thought you'd let an old woman bluff you out because she didn't have her clothes on.
Ah, she wouldn't have taken them off if Dave was there.
You remember what I told you? You know what you've got to do?
Come on.
I haven't seen him. If you do see him out on the road, come back and let me know.
I will.
Hey, come on!
Dave to relief.
Hey, come on.
What's the matter, Bill?
All right, kid.
taken it easier if I'd have known Day was inside. Where are you hiding him, Bill?
You're a friend of mine, Harry, but not that good a friend. And another thing. If Frank Ivey hears this, I'm going to kill you. Dead. Don't worry, he won't. I said dead. Hey, get up. Come on. Come on.
Keep the bandages and medicine separate. And see that he's warm. I'd like to talk to you. We'll go in the living room. Sit down, Connie. Frank Ivey was at my place yesterday, looking for Dave. He's been hurt. I've waited, but he didn't come home. You've seen him?
Yes. Bill's hiding him.
How is he?
Weak. All he needs is rest and quiet.
Why didn't you send word to me? Don't like me, do you?
I used to pity you, Connie. You got a rough deal from Frank and Ben. But your fight is costing too many lives. It's not worth it.
Isn't it?
Not if Frank gets Dave. He's the only thing that matters to me.
It happens I feel the same way, too.
Not the same, Connie. You want him along with revenge and power. You're letting him break himself on your greed and ambition.
I told him that, I suppose.
You don't tell a man about a woman. He has to find that out for himself.
Where is he?
Frank Ivey will be watching all of us. Especially you. The only way he can get to Dave is by following someone who goes to him. You'll never find out from me where he is, Connie.
You still hungry?
What good did it do me? Any salt left?
No. The roads are sending up some more grub. You know, someday a man's going to stop it from taking it straight.
Like this?
Yeah. I just wonder what to do.
Has she got a man?
Well, she can take me right off the Christmas tree of the day. But she knows I'm a Christian. Jim Crew always said, no one ever fools the roads very much.
I just can't figure it out. It may die to cut loose his dogs. He was playing for Crew, same as we were.
Well, he probably got a wild streak.
No, he just don't fit. He knew Stampede and Connie's hurt to bring Crew down on him. If he wanted to kill him, there are easier ways.
Well, he did, that's enough. We're licked.
No. There's just one load in the gun between Connie and what she wants. The load that gets Ivy.
Never mind. Seen Ivy work. Anyway, you're hitting the ride out of here.
Tell you to be followed?
I didn't know whether Dave was dead or alive. What was I supposed to do?
Wait. It's the same thing Rose is doing.
I was careful. I wasn't followed. Does Dave know the truth about the Stampede, Bill?
Not from me.
Feel the way you must feel about killing Ed Berman.
You don't know. You just guess.
I know. That's your secret, Bill. The stampede's mine.
Sounds like a deal.
It is.
Breached that Burma and got him cold. And I ain't sorry. I figured you did.
Came up here to help you. All I've done is put the whole pack on your trail.
You would have to come sometime. All I'll remember is that you did come.
I'll be waiting for you, Dave. If you come back.
I will. I promise. Connie, you want to be sure and get him killed. Just keep right on talking.
Corny up there.
Yeah. It'll take him plenty of time. Dave needs that. Thanks to you.
Not much use for me, haven't Bill?
You're like a horse or a dog or a man or any other woman. Once I understand you, you're all right.
They stop you down, you ride with me, not Dave. They won't believe it.
Thank you. the town.
Nice wouldn't take that.
You two better follow it anyway. Come over with us, Pop.
He must want to get himself shot taking this trail.
We'll accommodate him.
We got plenty of time.
We're waiting.
You'll have to get mighty close
to
that, Frank.
I'll get close. Bob, take the ridge. You take the coal outside.
Thank you.
Link? Link! Sit down, I'll get you some water.
Got me on the run, Ben. I'll be beating the brush for me.
I know, they are now. Link?
Get him a fresh horse.
Ivey shouldn't have gotten Bill Shell that way.
How?
A shotgun in the back.
Dave? Miss Connie isn't blaming me, is she? I haven't told you so, not even Mr. Dickerson.
Tired, son, you'll have to talk plain.
Ivey didn't find out from me. Maybe Bill Shell told him.
Told him what?
Oh, don't treat me like I was 4 years old. When I told Miss Connie I seen it, she admitted giving the orders.
Orders for what, Link?
For her own men to stampede her cattle out of the country. Close with that. But you won't.
Now is our happiness, our freedom, the way we want to live.
Not we, Connie. Just you, alone.
I don't want it alone.
So you don't want it alone? I guess that squares everything.
Thank you.
sure is a pretty dress.
You like it?